So today we are going to deal with the chapter that is coordination compound. So in your last class you have learned regarding the theory which was proposed by Wallace. Okay, so he has told to fulfill if you want to fulfill the coordination compound, then it should fulfill the primary valence as well as secondary valence. So it is compulsory that you should have both primary valence as well as secondary valence. So primary valence you can identify by identifying or finding the oxidation state, as well as secondary valence you can identify by going with the coordination number. Okay, so that is nothing but the primary valence as well as secondary valence. And what will be the nature of the primary valence, how it will get satisfied, so all those things we have studied under Wallace theory. And we have also started with some of the basic terms that you need to understand, you need to remember under this chapter. That is nothing but central atom which is present in the center, okay, so which will be considered as Lewis acid because it acts as the electron. So then next you have learned regarding ligands. So ligands are nothing but which will present around the central atom, okay, the groups which will form bond with your central atom, so that will be considered as ligand. So that will be considered as Lewis base, because it is a good donor, it is ready to donate the electron pair, will be considered as ligand. So under that type you have learned monodentate ligand as well as didentate ligand and polydentate ligand. So as the name indicates, the number of ligands it donates, it will increases. So the ambidentate ligand which goes with the same compound, so if you consider a compound, so that will be having two different donor group, will be considered as ambidentate ligand. And other than your monodentate ligand, all the ligands we will be calling as a chelate ligand, because it acts like claw. Okay, so how the claw will add or help for to use with utensils and all, in the same way to hold the utensils, in the same way your ligands also will help form a bond with your metal atom. Okay, to hold the metal atom. Okay, how that claw will hold in the same way, so we will consider that as chelate ligand. All the process will be considered as chelation. And the concept we have learned regarding coordination number. Coordination number is nothing but the number of ligands which is present in the central atom, okay, which will form sigma bond. There it should form only with a sigma bond. That only you are going to consider as coordination number. For pi bond you cannot. Okay. And coordination polyhedron, which is nothing but a spatial arrangement. If the coordination number is 4, then you can go with the polyhedral structure. In a sense, you can say that is a tetrahedral structure, okay, or square pyramidal structure. So in that way, okay. So based on that, in the sense, based on the coordination number, you are going to obtain the geometry, a 3D arrangement or the spatial arrangement of the structure, which will be considered as coordination polyhedron. And coordination entity, which is nothing but the central metal atom as well as the ligands. If you have written in terms of square bracket, will be considered as coordination entity. Coordination sphere is nothing but if it is having the charges, okay, either cationic charges will be there or anionic charges will be there. In the sense, either your coordination entity will be having positive charge, will be considered as cationic species. If it is having negative charge, will be considered as anionic species. So that is nothing but coordination sphere. And the last concept that you have learned, that is nothing but homolyptic and heteroleptic. Homolyptic in the sense, if it is having same kind of ligands, okay, so that will be considered as homolyptic. If it is having different kinds of ligands around the central atom, so will be considered as heteroleptic. And the last concept that you need to study, that is nothing but oxidation number of central metal atom. How to find our oxidation number? Now when you say with the primary valency is nothing but writing the oxidation state of the central metal atom. Sometimes you will be not knowing what will be the oxidation state of central metal atom. So how to find out that oxidation number? See, you have studied redox reaction, how we are going to be, we are going to deal with the oxidation state in the same way here also. Oxidation number of central metal atom. First we need to consider this is central atom. So here example, if I take cobalt is a central atom, so this I consider X. This I need to find out. Okay. So for this I consider as X plus what is the charge of NH3 molecules? So that is 0, that is a neutral atom. Okay, charge of NH3 molecule is 0, that is nothing but 0 into 6. How many NH3 molecules are present? So that is nothing but 6. Right? Now, plus here Cl is present. So what is the charge of Cl? That is minus 1. Right? Cl charge will be minus 1. How many Cl molecules are present? That is nothing but 3. E is equal to 0. Because you don't have one charge over here, what it was? 0 into 6, that is 0. Minus 1 into 3, that is minus 3, is equal to 0. So x is equal to plus 3. So here the oxidation state of cobalt will be plus 3. Okay, so in this way you need to find. So now you go for this, try to find by yourself. For this, so which is the central atom? That is copper is the central atom, right? So I'll represent as x. I take it as x, okay? And plus here, cyanide, the charge will be minus 1 into 4 is equal to whole charge they have given, that is minus 3, write down here. Okay, so now x minus 1 into 4, that is minus 4 is equal to minus 3. So minus 4, if it that, I mean, because that's it, plus 4, so the charge will be plus 5. Okay, so this, the charge of copper here, it will be plus 1. In this way, you need to find out the oxidation number or oxidation state of the central metal atom. So we will continue with the IUPAC structure now. So the next term that we need to understand under this chapter, that is nomenclature, very important part. So now here first we will go with the writing the formula of mononuclear coordination compound. Okay? In the sense, when we go with the coordination compound, how to write the formula? Okay, for formula, how it will be written? For mononuclear group, we are going to see now. Okay, so the first point that you need to remember, cation should be written first, which is followed by anion. Cation in the sense which is having positive charge, so that should be written first. Then you are supposed to write the negative charge too. For example, if I will say, for this example, if I will write over here, just copy down the points. Okay, so now K4 Fp Cn6, this is the coordination compound. So now here if you consider, this is cation, okay, positive charge ion, and this is your negatively charged ion, this is anion, okay. So here if you want, you can write down, this is as cation and this is your anion. So according to the rule, always cation should be, cation formula when you are writing, cation you are supposed to write first, then you are supposed to write the anion, okay. Sometimes you will be having group in this order also. Your coordination here, entity, it will be having the catalytic charges. So by the way, you can write in this form. See, if you consider with this. Okay, so this is another example. So if you go with this, you know what is the charge of Cn? So that is negative. So this is nothing but your anion. Okay. And this is your cation. Right? So according to the rule, so cation should be written first, which is having the positive charge. So this is having positive charge. So the positive ion only you are supposed to write first, then you are supposed to, it should be followed by the negative ion. Okay? So that is the first one. Cation should be written first, followed by the anion. This is the first rule. Second rule, for coordination sphere, the central atom first, ligand in alphabetical order. Okay, now you have a group. So there you think you have a cobalt group, this is cobalt, it is central atom, and you have a nitro group is present, okay. So you just take 3 nitro groups are present, as well as you have NH3 molecules are present. You will consider this example, okay. So now what I have to give for coordination sphere, okay, in the sense whatever you are writing inside the bracket, okay. For a coordination sphere, central atom should be written first. So in this you will consider which is the central atom. So that is nothing but your CO, cobalt will be the central atom. Okay. And ligands in alphabetical order, what if the ligands are present? Nitro groups are present, amine groups are present. So they should be written in terms of alphabetical order. So this is N. Okay, first alphabet is N. So this is A. So which should come first? This should come first. So when you are writing NH3 thrice, as well as later nitro group NO2 thrice. In this way you need to write. And very important thing here you need to remember, when you are writing polyatomic ligands, see this is NH3, molecules are thrice. Okay, this is polyatomic group, right? So when the polyatomic groups are present, so by the atom it should be mentioned in terms of bracket. Okay, so it should be written in terms of bracket. And you are not supposed to give much space between them. You should not give space between them. Continuously you are supposed to write. Space in the sense what? Here if you have cobalt, after some time you are going to write NH3 molecules. after some time you are going to try them everything, that will not suppose well. So you should not have space between them. Okay? So the space also you are not supposed to give. So this is regarding the second rule for coordination sphere. Central atom first, ligands in alphabetical order you need to write. Okay, so this is the second rule. Now we will go with the third one. Third one, it says that charges indicated outside the square bracket as a right substrate with a number before the sign. In a sense, when you are writing the charges, okay, for whole cationic charges will be there, anionic charges will be there. When you write the charge for whole ionic species, in a sense, without writing the counter ion. Counter ion means what? So if you have a group, for example, this group you will consider. Okay? So this is your coordination sphere. It is having charges also. Okay? So this is coordination sphere. So outside the square bracket, whatever you are writing, so that will be considered as counter ion. So if you are not writing counter ion, when you are writing only the ionic species, by that time the charge value will represent, then you need to follow this rule. So charge is indicated outside the square bracket. Okay? Outside the square bracket, you have to write as the right substrate. In a sense, the right side will be to your right side. Okay? So right side will be your supposed write as a substrate you have to write with a number before the sign. While writing, number should be written first, then sign should be written. Okay? So this is the rule that when you need to follow when you go with the number. For example, cobalt, different group I take, cyanide group I take, okay? 6, 3 minus, the charge which this is having, this is your anionic species, see? Okay? So, negative charge, anionic species, so here the charge if it goes with a 3 minus, the charge is 3 minus. So, when you are writing, as a substrate, you have right to your right side, and here the number, later you might be represented in the sign. So, if you go with another example, Cr, chromium binding as a central metal atom, okay, then water, 6 times, 3 plus, square bracket should be written, okay. So, this is another example. See, and also you just see chromium, exact twice present, okay. So, 3 plus the charge which is this, species is having, so it is not any species, positive charge it is having, 3 plus will be the charge. So, 3 will be the, in a sense, the number you need to write first, then you have to write the sign, okay. The last one, the charge of cation is balanced by charge of anion. Whatever the cation you will take, so whatever the charge of cation will be there, so that will be balanced by anion. So, if this molecule, the cation species is having 3 plus, now see these, once it shows minus 1 charge, so 3 CS are present, this is the charge is 3 minus. So, cationic charges will be balanced by charge of the anion. So, this is when you write a formula, okay. Remember, I am not going with the nomenclature IUPAC system. Now, here just a formula. When you are writing the formula, you need to remember this point because this is a complex compound. Till now, you have not done any complex compound. You have not gone through the complex compound. Simple compound you have identified, you have done with the reaction. So, this is a complex compound when you take, you need to follow these rules whenever the compound will be written. Okay? So, this is regarding the writing formula of mononuclear coordination compound. So, next we will go with the writing the name of the complex. Okay? How to go with the exact the nomenclature part. So, these are steps in the sense, even it is having some rules. So, the first rule that goes with, so the cation is named first, followed by anion. So, here also same thing, you should consider first when they give compound, first you find it out which is the cation and which is the anion. For example, here two examples I have taken. Okay. So, if I will consider this example, so which is the cation? You know, potassium is plus charge, K plus, right? So, this will be the cation, so this will be the anion. So, while naming, first the potassium should come. Okay, first potassium, then you are supposed to go with the naming with this complex ion. So, this will be considered as complex ion. First, cation which you are supposed to name first. Okay, so then you are supposed to go with complex ion. Okay, so here the potassium only should come first. Potassium. Understood? So, here if you go, you know what is the charge of Cl, that is minus charge. Obviously, this complex ion will be having positive charge. So, here also same thing, cation should be named first. In the sense, first this complex compound you have to name, then this negative charge ion will be named at last. Okay? So, That is the first rule. Next, the second rule. In naming of complex ion, next we are going with the complex ion that you will name. How we are supposed to name? Now if you understood, scattered only you should name first. Okay. If cation, pre-ion, if it is first like this, you can name. Okay, you can start like this. If cation is a complex compound, or here also name the complex compound is present next, so how to name this complex ions? Okay. So if complex ion you are naming, so the ligands are named first in alphabetical order. So the ligands which is present. So here if we consider, now we are going with complex ion. So this is your complex ion. Here this is your complex ion. So when you name, first we have to name the ligand. So here if we consider, this is your centripetal atom and this is your ligand. Okay. For that sake only in last class I have taught you what is the centripetal atom, ligands, and all. So here if you consider, this is your centripetal atom and this is your ligand. So now here by naming, first if you consider these two, your ligand only should be named first. Okay. In the sense, this cyanide group you have to name first. Then you have to go with your centripetal atom. Now, if you will consider this as an example. Here what is happening? You are having two ligands. Here water molecule are also, see this is your centripetal atom. So around this, water is also present as a ligand, as well as your Cl2 molecule is also present as a ligand. So two ligands are there. If two ligands are present, then you are supposed to name in alphabetical order. So which one will come first? So this will be named as aqua. This is your chlorine. Right? So which will come first? A will come first, after that C, alphabetical order. So this you are supposed to name first. Okay? So remember, while naming for complex ion, first you have to name the ligand, then you have to go for central ligand. If it is having number of ligands, okay, so by then according to alphabetical order, the name should be given. Okay? So that is second one. Next, the third rule says that use prefix as di, prime, tetra, etc. Now you have to use prefix in the sense number of ligands if it is present. So here 6 cyanide group is present. So how you will name hexacyano? Right? So 6 cyanide group is present, so hexacyano. In the sense prefix you have to use di, tetra, tri, tetra, penta, hexa, hepta, octa. Okay, so that we continue. So here you are supposed to use prefix and you have to name the compound. So here also same thing. If you are naming aqua group first, what is the prefix that you have to name? 4 aqua groups are present. So tetra aqua dichloro. Okay, so in that way you have to name. Okay, so you are supposed to use prefix. Next, if ligand name already consists of prefix, then we use bis, cis, tetra, cis, etc. In a sense, now for example, you take one more example as En. In last class you have studied, right? What is mean by EN? EN is nothing but ethane 1,2-diamine, right? So now there, if you go there, it shows a 2-donor group, right? So dipeptide ligand it is. So 2-donor group will be present. So why name only? The name, that name only will be said ethyl diamine, right? So there in the name only there are we have mentioned diamine is present. So prefix already mentioned in its own name. So if it is there like that, its own name it is having a name, in the sense your prefix is present. By then, by naming, now this is nothing but your ethyl 1,2-diamine, right? So now it is already having this prefix as di. So while naming, in the sense for nomenclature when you are naming, by that time this should be written as see how many EN groups are there? 2. In the sense bis you have to take. So you have to write bis or ethylene di 1,2-diamine. 1,2-diamine. So in this way the name of the compound will be given. You understood? So now what is the name has been given for the compound? The real name will be there, right? If it is already having a prefix. Okay? If already it is having a prefix, by then, by naming the nomenclature, for this, by seeing this. Okay, so you can find out or you can write on as you can use bis, cis, tetra, cis, in a sense, you are supposed to use a secondary prefix. Okay, next prefix you have to use over here. Okay? So in this way you need to name. Understood? So this is regarding the fourth point. Next, fifth point. If the complex is a cation, the metal is made as same as the element. If the complex ion they are same. a complex ion. Okay, so the complex ion, if it is cation, the metal ring or any, it should be taken as it is. Chromium is present since chromium only you have right when you are writing any. If the complex is anion, if the complex ion is your anion, okay, then the name of the metal should end with A. Metal name when you are writing, this is fer, right? So when you write with this ferrate, understood? Okay, cuprate. So in that way, H you are supposed to add, understood? So when you write a central metal, I. So according to that, and very important thing here, so the when you are writing nomenclature for metal, when you will write, right? For that, you need to write as oxidation state. You know now how to write an oxidation number? So the whatever the oxidation number of central metal atom will be there, so that also it is compulsory to go with when you write the nomenclature part. So we'll go or we'll write with the nomenclature or the naming of this compound. So in this first you are interact, this is the cation and this is the anion. So this is the cation and this is the anion. Right? So cation always it should be named first. So that is something but potassium. Cation should be named first. Now this is your complex ion. So complex ion, first the ligand should be named. This is the ligand. So how many ligands are present? Six. So in the sense, potassium hexacyano. Okay, potassium hexacyano. This is your iron group. Okay. So as I said, so if it is anion, complex ion, if it is anion, then the central metal atom should be named as AAA. So it is ferrate. Potassium hexacyanoferrate. So what is oxidation state of iron? See, K plus is plus 1 into 4. Charge of potassium is plus 1 into 4. Okay. Plus iron you don't know, you need to find. So that is X. Okay. Cyanide group, that is minus 1. Minus 1 into 6. So now it is equal to 0. Fine. Now write down, so 4 into 1 that is 4 plus x, 1 into 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. So what will be the oxidation state of potassium? That is minus 6 plus 4 is minus 2, minus 2 when it goes that side, that is plus 2. So oxidation state will be 2. So you need to write in this. Okay, Roman number you need to write down. Okay, so where the central metal atom will be there, there you have to write it down. You have to mention. Okay, so that is nothing but the naming of the compound. In this way, you can name. We'll go with another. We'll go in this compound. If you check CrH2O4Cl2, as well as this is your coordination sphere. It is having charge Cl minus, right? So first you need to identify the positive ion as well as negative ion is present. So this is the negative ion and this is the positive ion. It is present. So now what you have to do? So positive ion you need to name the first. We need to name first. So this is your complex ion. Positive ion is a complex ion. So here first what you have to do? You have to go with the ligand. So these are the ligands. Okay, so in this also alphabetical order you need to name, right? So here aqua group is present, chloro group is present. So how to name? How many aqua group is present? 4. So that is tetra aqua. Tetraaqua, dichloro, then next you have to go with your central metal atom. So that is chromium as it is, because if it is cation, no need to worry. Chromium as it is, metal ion it is present, then that way you have to write chromium. Oxidation state you have to write, okay? Chromium outside Cl minus is the chloride. So find oxidation state or oxidation number of chromium. So how to find out? So that is X plus H2O, one neutral molecule, so oxidation number is 0, 0 into 4, that is 0 itself, and Cl minus 1, minus 1 into 2, so that is minus 2. Again here the charge of this Cl is minus 1, is equal to 0. So X is equal to X minus 3 is equal to 0, so X is equal to plus 3. So the oxidation state of chromium is plus 3. In terms of 3, you need to show. So in this way, you are supposed to go with the nomenclature or naming of the compound. So when you write the name or the nomenclature part, when you do, you need to remember those points. So students, next we will go with the table. Okay, so this table will help you to write the last point whatever we have discussed, in the sense the rule of nomenclature. In the sense, if you have a cation, okay, if you have cationic species as a complex ion, by that time you know the charge value, in the sense the center metal atom as it is, you have to write. Okay, if it is different, in the sense if it is an anionic species, okay, so if that compound or the complex ion is anionic species, by that time the central atom name will be, it should be ended with AT. So how it will be done? See, for example, now if you take chromium metal, okay, so this chromium metal, if it is present in the cationic species, if it is having positive charge, then chromium only you have to write and you have to end. Okay, and in the sense the continuation of the nomenclature will be done. The metal name should be written as chromium itself. And if it is present in anionic species, okay, so by that time it should be chromate. Okay, the name of the chromium you have write it as chromate. So in the same way, so just copy down the list. So this table will help you out how to go with the, the naming of the compound. If your metal is platinum, the cationic part you are supposed to go with platinum. Like that only you have to write. For anionic part you have to end with platinate. Okay, for cobalt, so cationic part you have to write as cobalt itself, but anionic ending it should be ATE, cobaltate. Okay, so nickel, nickel, and nickelate should be the anionic species. Zinc, for cation, if zinc is present in cation, in the sense if it is present in a positive charged ion, so if zinc is present over here, for positive charge ion, so it should be written as zinc itself by nomenclature or by naming the compound. If it is an anionic species, by that time zinc should be end with zincate. Okay, the name of the zinc should end with zincate. Okay, so in this way, you need to write. So palladium, it says palladium itself, but here palladate. Titanium, titanium itself, titanate. Vanadium, vanadium. In cationic part, it says for cationic part, as it is, you have to write. Okay, but when you write, if it is an anion, then we should end with ATE, vanadate. Okay, molybdenum, molybdate. And in species, lead, lead only you have to write. Your plumbate, you have to write. Okay, and if it is a silver, silver only you have to take. Your argentate, you have to write. Okay, and for gold, gold only you can take, but while anionic species are writing, iron you have to write. Okay, for tin, tin only you have to write, but while writing anionic species, stannate you have to write. For iron, iron only you have to write, but anionic species when you are writing, ferrite you have to write. So you need to remember this table. Okay, so just remember this table for your competitive exam also. This will help you out while writing the name. For competitive exam, this naming nomenclature part will be asked for you people. As well as for one more question and all, they will ask you to write the name of the compound. By then, you have to go with this. So, today you need to learn regarding this. So, this is regarding the name of the metal atom or ion. So, next we will go with the naming of the compound. Some example I have given. So, here first you have to check, this is a cation as well as anion species. So, this is negative and obviously this will be the positive species. So complex ion is present. So complex ion in the sense, this I have done already. So how we have done before, like that only. NH3 molecule, amine is present as well as aqua is present. Okay. So while naming here amine as well as aqua, again see both are starting with A, right? So next thing that you need to consider, amine M, next Q will come. So this will give tetane. Okay, alphabetical order, amine only will come first. So naming will come as triamine, aqua, here chromium, chromium. You need to write the oxidation state. Find the oxidation state of chromium, chloride or trichloride. Trichloride. Find the oxidation state of chromium and iron. Okay, so this is nothing but the compound name. Just check the oxidation state. Okay, what is the oxidation state you will get, that you need to write over there. Fine. Next one. This one, platinum, as well as you are here, you are having NH2, CH2, CH2, NH2. So that is nothing but EN, 3-ethane diamine, 1-diamine group, right? So this group EN, already the name is here. Okay, prefix is sir has died. So for this, again, twice it is given the sense this year name. Okay. So while naming, see, this is one thing and this is another thing. So you, here you have EN group and then here you have curve. Which you need to name first according to alphabetical E or C. C you have to write. So the name will come as dichloro. You know why I am naming this? Because this is a positive ion, right? So dichloro. So bis EN. In the sense, two times EN groups are present. Okay. Bis EN. Platinum. Platinum. Find oxidation state over here also. And here this is chloride. Okay. So in this way, you need to name with the compound. We'll go with the next group. Next group will go. So in the sense, example, that is platinum. So here also same thing. Check with the platinum here. Oxidation state comes around 4, I guess. Check. Okay. So next we'll go with this compound. Naming of this compound. So here you are having amino group. Cl group is present. So while naming, so see here cationic species, anion species. I mean, you don't have coordination sphere only. So while naming, same thing here. These are the ligand and this is the central atom. So amine groups are present, chlorine groups are present. So how to name? See, amine will come first. So it comes as diamine, diamine. Here Cl group is present. So tetrachlorido, tetrachlorido, platinum. Platinum is your central atom. So platinum. You need to find oxidation state over here. Find and write down here. Okay. Next compound if you will go, iron is there as well as your carbonyl group is present. The five types, right? So how to name pentacarbonyl? This is nothing but your iron. Pentacarbonyl iron. So what is the state of oxidation state of or oxidation number of iron? Find it out and write down over here. So it comes around 0, I guess. Okay, just check up. So this will be the name pentacarbonyl ion. So in this thing you need to write the compound name. So whenever you will write the name of the compound, cationic species, anion species, you need to check. Along with that, you need to check with your ligands. Okay. So alphabetical order you have to name as well as oxidation state also you have to write it out.